everyone, my name is Shambhavi. Hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to make out a spelling checker project. So in that basically what will happen, what are the spelling you are going to enter out, it will basically check out that spelling, that whether that spelling is correct or wrong. If that spelling is wrong, it will let you know the correct spelling, and if the spelling is correct, it will display that particular correct spelling only. Let me just run out here. Okay, so here we have this spelling checker which we are gonna make out today. It will look out like this. Okay, this is my entry box which I had made here. Let's say I just put out a spelling. Let's say data. I just want to put out the spelling for data. But I had just put out double A. We all know that that is wrong. Right now, if as soon as I click on the check button, so what it will display that the correct spelling is data. Like this, right? If I just run it out like this and I would just put out here, let's say programming. Okay, I would just write here programming. The spelling which I had put out here is wrong. That is double M, right? So if I just click on check, see what it displayed. It displayed the correct spelling is programming, double M-I-N-G. Right? So this is how the project is going to be today. And this is the project which we are going to make today. Right? So let's get started. So what I would just do here is that I would just let you know the libraries that we'll be using out. As I mentioned that it is a GUI Python project. So in that case, we'll be using out a tkinter library. That is the first thing. Second thing, we have a library in Python programming that is TextBlob, T-E-X-T-B-L-O-B. That particular library is used for actually checking out the spellings, for checking out that whether the spelling which you have entered is right or wrong, and even displaying out the correct spelling of that particular word. Right, this is how this TextBlob library actually works. So we are going to use out that particular library throughout the project. So I would just go onto a terminal first of all and just install out that text blob library. So I would just write here pip install, and that is T-E-X-T-B-L-O-B, and I would just hit out enter. So for me, actually, I have already done that. So for me, it is showing that requirement already satisfied. If you haven't done that thing till now, so it will show that installing, and after some time, it will show successfully installed. Right, so I have just done out that particular thing, and the ID which I'm taking out here is PyCharm. You can just make out this project onto any of the IDs, let's say VS Code or Sublime Text or Python, whatever you just want out. Fine. So I would just import out, and before importing, I would just write out from tkinter. I would just write here from tkinter import asterisk. Okay, so from tkinter import asterisk. So tkinter is basically my library, and from that asterisk means that I'm importing all of the functions which basically I have into this tkinter library. Next line, I would be just writing here that from textblob, the library which we have installed right now, from that library, I'm writing here import textblob. Now, this textblob is basically just of my library, right? And this textblob, this which I have written after the import function. So this is basically one of my functions which I have into this library, and that is, and this one, this text blob, this is necessarily used for checking out the spellings, right? So from text blob, import text blobs, make sure that here T and B are actually small, and after the import one, this T and B are actually capital. Make sure to write out the things very correctly. Right, now after we have imported out the libraries, now my second task is to make out a tkinter window, right? When I just showed you the example output for that, the final output of this program, so there you are able to see out a tkinter window, right? In that window, we'll be giving out some specifications. Let's do that. I will just write here window is equal to tk like this, okay? And after that, I'd be writing here. So this, okay, window is my variable in which I am storing my tkinter window, which I am actually willing out to make out here. This tk is a window which I am making out of my tkinter, fine? After this, I'll be giving out a particular title, first of all, to this. So window.title, okay? And the title is basically my spelling. I would just write here my spelling checker. Okay, my spelling checker, fine? That is done. Now what I would just do here is that I'll be coming down at this particular place, and here I'd be using out the geometry. So that is window.geometry. Now what geometry do I want? I mean that what length and width I just want of this particular tkinter window that would be appearing. Fine. Let's say I just want it 800 x 600. Now this is not my multiplication sign, this is my x, small x character which I am having into the alphabets, okay? Make sure to put that only. And after the giving out this geometry, you had seen that a tkinter window that was appearing. In that, basically we were having a light green color at the background of the tkinter window, right? So in that case, I'd be giving out window.config. into the bracket I'll be writing here, background is equal to, and color which I just want to give out here is light green. Okay, it totally depends on you what color you just want to give out. You can just put any of your choice, right? And as we know that we are making out this program, this project with the help of the key enter window. So it's our basically rule to put out the main loop at the last so as to run out our program. Right now, I would just try to run out this particular project here. So as soon as I do it, see, this is my key enter window, which is actually appearing to me. It is having the title My Spelling Checker, and the dimensions are 800x600, and basically the background color is light green. Right, I would just close it out now. Fine, this is all set up. Now what I would just do here is that I would be making out different text to it. Now what type of text? You had seen that when I ran out the program. So on that, basically, first of all, on the above side was written a spelling checker. After that, it was written that enter the word. After that, an entry box was there in which you were entering your the text whichever you just wanted to check out. And after that, there was a check button, right? This was all which was present at that particular place. So all of these things we are going to mention out right now. So first of all, I just want to give out a particular heading, right? I would just write here text _ heading. Okay, my variable that is heading like this. Okay, put out equal to sign. And as we all know that whenever we just want to print out any text onto a tick in the window, we always use out the function which is label. Right, I'm just using out that label function here. Inside the bracket, I'll be putting out the variable in which I have stored out my tick into window, that is window for me. And here I go on with the parameter, which is tick. Now, what text I just want to display onto that tick into window? So, that is basically, let's say, spelling check. Okay, I just want to display out this particular text. After that, I want to give out a particular font as well. So, font is equal to my font, which I want to give out here is Arial. The size which I want to put out is, let's say, 50. And yes, I just want that into be the bold, right? So I just put out that particular thing. After that, coming out of the bracket for the font function, for the font variable, sorry, for the font parameter, I will just put out a comma and give it out some specifications for the color. So BG is equal to, now what background color I just want? So let's say I just want my background color to be black for this particular heading, okay? And FG is basically my foreground color, that is my font color. So what font color you just want to give out? So let's say I just want to give out the font color, that is light pink. Okay, so this is all what I just want to give out here. And now what I would just do here is that I'll be using out the pack function to put out all the things which I have written onto the tick enter window. Right, so that I have done out here. Now it's the time for running out of the project. I'll just click out run here and let's run it. Fine, so now just have a look that I'm just getting out my very first heading, that is spelling checker, onto the top, right? And the background is black and whatever is written here, that is of the light pink color. Fine, let's close it out. Now what I would just do here is that, let me come to the next line. After displaying out this, I was even having a heading which was that enter the word. Okay, enter the word or enter the text, whatever we just want to put out, right? So let's do that particular thing. Okay, so I would just write here text _ tick, my variable. Okay, put out equal to sign. Again, I'd be using out that label, same function label into the bracket. I'd be using out here the window, comma. What text do I just want to print out now? So I would just put out that enter the text. Okay, enter text, because it's not only for the spelling. You can just put out any of the text as well, fine. Put out a comma. I would just write, okay, let me just, instead of that, let me just put out spelling only. That looks like more clear and more nicer, okay? So, font is equal to, put out the bracket like this, and the last bracket, this one, right? The font is basically, I just want to give it to the Arial, same which I had given above, but the size would decrease, that is around, size would come as around, let's say 35, okay? And yeah, I just want that to be in the bold. What about my BG color and my font color? So just one second. So here after this, I'd be putting out a comma and BG color, which I just want to give out here is yellow. Okay. And what about my FG color? That is my font color. So that I just want to give out here as red. Come to the new line and I would just write here text _ check and use out the pack function for putting out all of the things onto the tick in the window. And here's the time for running. And yes, have a look that I had just got out my second label, which is enter the spelling. fine. Let's close this as well. Okay, this is as well written. Now, after this, what I just want to do, I just want to make out an entry box in which I'll be putting out my spelling, which I just want to check out, right? So, let's make out that particular thing. Fine. So, I would just write here spell underscore check. Okay, spell underscore check my variable name, which I had just put out here. Okay. So, now after this, what I would just do here is that I would be using out the function now, which is entry. Okay, make sure to put out that thing. Entry. After that, the variable, which is window, putting out a comma. I would be just giving out here the font. Because text, I would be taking at that place only. So, I would just not describe the text before this. Because it's the entry box, which I am making, right? Text is equal to Arial. Size would be 45. And yes, that would be bold. Fine. Okay. Now we'll be giving out some width as well to that box that will be, the entry box will be appearing. So that is, let's say, 500, which I had given out, fine. And what about my BG color? So BG color, I just want to give here as light blue, okay. And yeah, after coming down, I would just put out here the spell underscore check dot pack. So that is spell underscore check dot pack and the bracket. Now it's the time for again running out my program. So let's run it out here. And okay, light blue. Okay, spelling is wrong. Just one second. Let me correct that out. So here we have L-I-G-H-T we have. Okay, now it's okay. Let's run it out here. Fine. So basically, yes, this is my window which is appearing. Yes, now I could just write anything here. Let's say anything I could just write out. Fine. Okay, let's close it out here. And after this, what we need to make out? We need to make out a button. That button, that is a check button, right? Okay, so I would just write here check underscore button, my variable name. Check underscore button, that is my variable name. So here I'd be using out the function which is button. Okay, put out the bracket. And I just write here as window, my variable name. After that, okay, after first of all, text. What text you just want to print inside that button? So that is basically check. Okay, just one second, check like this, right? Okay, let it be one single only. Fine. Okay, putting out a comma, I would be entering out some font. Let's say font is equal to, I would be just giving that as well. So Arial. After that, what do I have? Let's say the size, I just want it to be as 30. Okay, and after that, I just want that to be in the bold. After that, what about my FG color? So FG would be white for me. I just want the text written to be in the white. And what about my BG color? BG color would be red for me. Okay, just one more thing. I am just defining out a command. I'm just finding out a command here. That will be one of the functions that will be declaring above. Okay, that will be declaring above. Right now, I'm just defining it. Okay, let's not define that because if we are going to do that, it will result me the error. Because I'm just going to run it once again right here. Okay, so let's not do it. First, I will declare that it above. Then only I just put it inside the variable. Okay, so here I just put on the pack function and now let's try to run it out here. Fine, so I'm having my check button as well, which is as well working, but we haven't written and given any command, anything to follow, so it will not give me any type of error. So it will not give me any type of correct or any type of wrong things. Fine, now basically it's the time for defining out the function that will actually help me to check out that whether the spelling that I have written that is correct or wrong. So def, and I would just write here my function name, that is check underscore spelling. Okay, check underscore spelling, come down here. What I would just do here is that I would be first of all making out a variable. So that is, let's say my variable is, let's say A, I would give out here. Fine, simple variable. Into this variable, what I would just do here is this, I'm just using out that text blob function which I have imported above, because now this is one which will help me to do so. Now I would just come down here in the variable where I have used and where I just put out the entry function where I'll be entering out my spelling which I want to check, that variable I would be taking out now. So for me that is spell underscore check, right? So I would just write here inside the bracket I'd be writing spell underscore check dot and using out the get function. So this will basically help me to get out the correct spelling. right? To get out the spelling for that. Fine. After this, what I would just do? After this, I just want to display out the text, one text, that is the correct spelling is. And under that, I just want to display out the correct spelling, which is actually the correct spelling, right? So I would just write here. So I would just write here spell, my variable name is equal to, and I would just write here label, and into the bracket I'd be giving out the variable, which is window. Now these lines are actually exceptional. If you just want to add out, you can, and if you just do not want to, then don't do that. It's not any of the compulsions to add this as well, right? Text, we just want to add out here that the correct spelling is, because when I just showed you the final output of this program, so there you must have noticed out in the starting that as soon as I clicked on the check button, so the sentence was appearing that the correct spelling is, and under that statement the correct spelling of that particular word was appearing, right? So this is what I'm just trying to do out here. I'm just writing out that sentence. Fine. After that, putting out the font. So font basically is my Arial, and after that I have the size, let's say 30, and yes, I just want that to be into the bold, so that is absolutely okay. Putting out a comma, and what about my BG color? So BG color I just want to give out here as gray. Fine. Okay, now come down, and I will simply use that pack function. So that is spell dot pack under brackets like this. Fine, that is okay. Now what is left here? Now it's basically left for taking out my spelling and printing the correct spelling. So I would just write here the variable, which is correct underscore text. Okay, that is text. Okay, is equal to, using out my label function, into the bracket I'd be using out the variable, which is window. Putting out a comma here, I would be using out here my text. So text is equal to, now what is my text? So my text is, first of all, I'd be using out the str, into the bracket I would be using here now a dot, and that is correct, correct function. Now just have a look that what I had just done here. This is the main line of this particular program which we are writing actually. Okay, right here. Fine. So this a was a variable in which I have used out my text block function to check out the spelling, to get out the spelling for which we just want to check out, right? So this a was a variable which I had used out here for retrieving out that spelling which I wanted to check, right? And now here inside my text, what I'm just using, first of all, I'm typecasting that into the string format, that is, I'm taking out the str, the one or the other data types. I'm using out that particular function, that sorry, variable in which I have get out my, retrieved out my spelling which I wanted to check, and right now I'm using out the function which is correct. So this function will actually help me to correct out my wrong spelling, which if I have entered any of them, right? Okay, put out a comma, and now giving out my font details. So my font would be remaining same, that is Arial, but my size would differ, that is, let's say 45, and I want that to be into the bold. Comma, what about my BG color, which I just want to give out? So BG is equal to, and the color I want to give out is light pink, right? Coming down, I would just use here correct underscore text dot pack, and I would just use it out here. Now what is my function? That is check underscore spelling. Now the last task is to call out this function. So I would be calling this function inside my button which I had made out. So this is my variable, right? Okay, function name was check underscore spelling, right? Now let's come here, and comma, I put out a comma at the last right here. Command is equal to, and that is check underscore spelling, and try to remove out this bracket. Do not put the brackets after the function here, right? Why I had just put that into the button? Because as soon as I click on the button, that will let me know the correct spelling for my particular word which I had put on, right? So basically now what I would just do out here is that I'll be running out my program because we have completed out. So click on run, and yes, this is the whole program which is appearing. Now let me just give it some trial. Let's say I would just write here programming this word. I'm just click on check. Right, so just have a look here that it displayed me the correct spelling for this particular word, which is programming. So the correct spelling is P-R-O-G-R-A-M-M-I-N-G. Right, so this is actually working absolutely correct. And if I just give out a particular correct word, let's say I just give out the correct spelling. So in that case, it just gave me that same spelling which I have entered, which is correct. Right, let me close it out here. Right, so hope you just got a clear and a fair idea regarding this program, that how you can just make out spelling checker onto your own with the help of the Python programming language, and in that we are actually use the GUI, that is the graphical user interface, and with the help of that tkinter library. Right, so hope you enjoyed out this project. So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and take care.